Good afternoon, sirs and ma'am. Thank you. Yes, sir. Yes, sir, actually, it was because my grandmother was an ardent devotee of Lotus Parvati. So once I was born, she was like, we should give her a name of Lotus Parvati. So Arya is one among the names of
Lotus. It's not a common name in Kerala?
It's a very common name in Kerala, sir.
So, how's your training going
on? Yes, sir. I'm into Indian Postal Service. I'm 6 months now in training. It's going good, sir. Great.
Where is
it? In Ghaziabad, sir.
Ghaziabad. Okay. Post-related.
Yes, sir.
Who is the director?
Adil. Yes, sir. PM Lars.
Your father is in labor business?
Sir, he was in labor department of Kerala. Now he's retired.
Tell me, what problems he faced? Kerala is famous for labor issues. What problems he faced and what you learned from him?
Sir, in fact, my motivation to get into service itself was my father. So he was part, he raised from the lower cadre, he entered as a clerk. Then he got promotions and become a regional joint labor commissioner. So throughout his journey, he has been very grounded. And he was always ready to help people. So there were even people, blue collar workers, who used to come our home to seek help from him. So people need to be more aware about the provisions they have, like the rights they have, which derive from the labor laws. So he was always ready to help them. And once we had this conversation, so when he was saying, like, I cater to the demand of only a section of people, the laborers. If you can be in civil services, you can touch the lives of more number of people. So in fact, he's inspiration for me, sir.
Lot of awareness about labor laws and issues. That is the reason that there are hardly any industries in Kerala?
Sir, for that case, there are multiple factors. Sir. Kerala, as you know, is a geographically a very small state. So the availability of raw materials for industries is very less there. And also, sir, we are more into the service sector. So most of our population are either expatriates or who are working in the tertiary sector, sir.
No, sir. And this sector, because industries have not been established, they are not allowed to be established.
Sir, actually, it's a structural transgression, sir. Directly from the agriculture, we went to the service sector because of the high availability of education, literacy, and also. And also, this factory is already there, sir, because of the communist legacy. Kerala formed the first elected communist government in the world. So obviously, people's knowledge, especially the laborers' knowledge about labor laws and all, are very well. So the exploitation aspect, or rather adamant advocacy for their own rights, is always there, sir.
And that's why one industry has moved to Telangana.
Sir, they were not able to get proper facilities that they used to have. So one of the factors is that, and you know, sir, as a part of the cooperative federalism, competitive federalism that is happening, states are actually competing within themselves to provide better opportunities so that they can improve the ease of doing business. In that sense, Telangana, being an aspiring state, which was recently formed, is actually striving to get better business environment there.
NSS in the context of Kerala.
Sir?
NSS in the context of Kerala.
Nair Service Society. So Nair Service Society was formed by Mannath Padmanabhan in 1900s. So there, Mannath Padmanabhan himself was a social reformer who were part of bringing up the societies which were downtrodden section of the societies which were not actually represented. So he was formed, he was prominent part in the freedom struggle also. And more than that, he was actually involved in building educational institutions for the community. And
but
also,
is more in politics?
Sir, NSS as such is not that much a vocal factor in politics. Though the union is there, their play in the mainstream Kerala politics is very little compared to other dominant castes, sir.
Do we have elephant bay?
Elephant?
Bay.
Yes, sir. It was on 12th of September, sir.
Any other day?
Yes, sir. Tiger Day.
You have seen elephants in Kerala?
Yes, sir. They are a part of temple procession, sir.
Why that happened? I know they are
part. Sir, I never saw one in direct, sir. I have heard news in which this human-animal conflicts normally happen. So that is especially in the areas where forests are close to or plantations are nearby.
Are these elephants creating some problems
for
the humans also?
For the?
Humans also?
Yes, sir. Human-animal conflict these days is...
In the areas in Kerala.
Sir, especially in the Idukki, Wayanad regions, where 4SO plantations are more.
So what is being done to avoid that?
Sir, today, like just now, I was reading the Hindu newspaper. The government is taking over many of the plantations which are very close to the forest areas so that they can reduce the impact of human animal conflicts and the animals as such will have a better environment to live in.
Where are the major these plantations are there? Which areas?
Sir, in Idiki, there we have tea plantations. In my district, Kottayam, we have rubber plantations. And in Wayanad and all, spice plantations are there, sir.
And Nelliyampathi?
Nelliyampathi is also in Wayanad, sir.
Huh?
Wayanad.
Nelliyampathi in Wayanad?
Oh, sorry, sir. I'm not sure.
You're not seen?
No, no, sir. I haven't.
Nelliyampathi in Palakkad.
Okay, okay, sir. Sorry.
Dams in Kerala?
Sir, we have a number of dams. The one almost everyone must have heard is Mullaperiyar Dam issue. So that's a very old dam. And it was made of Surki. That's a kind of not so reinforced concrete, which was during the colonial times. So, sir, there is ongoing issues going about the safety of the dam because it is very old. And
Kerala, dams are there in Kerala?
I'm unable to recall the exact numbers.
Which is the biggest dam?
Biggest will be Idiki Dam, sir.
Yeah. These dams created a lot of problems in the previous back in Kerala.
Yes, sir, especially during the last Kerala floods, which was many years after Kerala witnessed such a large-scale flood in...
Man-made floods?
Sir, it was a combination of man-made and natural factors, sir. The incessant rainfall, which was distributed not over a long period, it was in a very short period, along with some issues with the dam management was also there, sir.
Has Kerala lost it to the COVID pandemic? This is the only state which has such high numbers of cases.
Sir, of late, I should admit that there has been some flaws in the policies that the Kerala government is following. One thing, in the beginning, Kerala was the first state to report a COVID case, and in that phase, we were really confident to trap it. But of late, what has happened is there was an opening up in between when there were not so number of cases for the elections and other festivities. So that has accelerated the number of cases on one. Second thing, all of us must have read in newspapers that the latest zero prevalence survey by ICMR has pointed that Kerala, the antigen prevalence is just 40%. So many of the people have been protected from the first wave, but that currently they are being affected by the second wave.
Any difference in policy between those which was given by Shailaja teacher and the new health minister?
Sir, basically the policy is remaining the same, but the thing is this opening up, and second thing is the relative less prevalence of zero, and the third thing is also that we were following a first line treatment center oriented policy in the first wave, but of late we are more focused on to home isolation. So what is happening is in many houses in Kerala, many of the people are not so aware about the isolation strategy. So one in the house, if they are testing positive, it is highly probable that all the individuals in the house are testing positive. That is also one of the reasons why high number of cases are coming up.
Can you tell us about Kottayam district?
Sir, Kottayam is famous for 3 L's, latex, letters and lakes, sir. And Kottayam is also popular for being the first 10% literate district in the state as such. And the Kottayam had the first for the L part, lakes because it has the Vembanad Lake, the lagoons, and latex because the Rubber Research Institute of India is located in Kerala, Kottayam, and also it has many rubber plantations. And for the letters part, the first printing press, the whole country was established in CMS College premises in Kerala. So.
The Kerala governor recently said that, you know, brides should be banned from jewelry advertisements.
Sorry,
brides,
sir?
Photos of brides should be banned from jewelry advertisements. Can you connect this to something that has recently happened in Kerala?
Yes, sir. Dowry-related deaths have happened of late, that too in a large number. So this is one of the main issues, sir, because dowry is seen as a symbol of status in the country, especially in Kerala, because there is an increasing inclination for gold jewelry. That has some historical factors as such. Added to that, the patriarchal system, which is in prominence, which see women as a property, which is being in transit from one home to the other. And along with that, some property or gold has to be transferred with them.
As a student of sociology, let's say that, you know, dowry deaths, suicides, that's on one side. And on the other side, you have high literacy, high education. What is this contradiction?
So it's a great anomaly which I myself has found interesting, sir. One part is that Kerala has advanced in terms of HDI, like health, education, per capita income, but still that primordial values of patriarchy are still resilient in the society as such, sir. Rather than that, women themselves has to be more assertive. They have to be financially independent. That is one of the factors that I found itself lacking, sir.
Kerala has very high participation of women at the panchayati level and grassroots level. But compared to states like Tamil Nadu or UP or even West Bengal, we don't see senior leadership by women. We have never seen a woman chief minister in Kerala.
Yes, sir. We never had a women chief minister as such. So there are two angles to this. One thing is that women empowerment is so pervasive in the country, in the state as such, so that we don't need, like, we should symbolize a women as chief ministers to showcase our women empowerment. That is one aspect. And the second is, sir, though we have participation of women at the lower cadres, at the higher cadres, there are very less number of women. So in this, it is like a replica of the entire country as such. So in that sense, I think Kerala has to improve in terms of the political participation of women in the highest cadres.
What is this upcycling?
Sir, upcycling is a kind of creative reuse. So in which you actually get use of something which is not of so much of value, and then you use your artistic skills and use it to usable objects, sir.
Plastic waste management amendment rules.
Sir, of late, even today, I have come across that India government is going for complete ban of single-use plastic by 2022. Kerala state have already implemented it in 2018. And rather than that, we have to be totally assured that the recycling of plastic has to be in place, and also the classification of plastic into single use and multi use, and the quality of plastic which is of recycling grade has to be promoted.
Do you think it will be possible to ban single use plastic because there are no alternatives?
Sir, alternatives are in place, sir. Actually, the cloth fabric based holders which we see these days are an alternative to single use plastic. Also, it is more about the behavioral change that we should bring in, sir. If we ourselves start behaving like we are taking a carry bag with us when we are going to the shop, then it can bring a lot of change, sir.
Last question. Malayalam short stories. Can you tell me one of the stories that you have written and crisply explain the plot of the story?
Sir, the latest one I have written is about the COVID pandemic and the separation of women. It's actually inspired from the experience of one of my friends. She was engaged to a long time relationship. So what happened is, like, he was working in UAE, and their marriage was supposed to happen in April last year. She was waiting for that, and unfortunately we lost him there, sir. So it is all about that longing for someone to come back and how she could lose.
BIMSTEC.
Sir, Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multisectoral Cooperation in Economics. So it is more about the Bay of Bengal littoral states, and it is seen mostly.
Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multisector.
Multisector Technical and Economic Cooperations. So it is more about the littoral states of the Bay of Bengal. And it is mostly seen as alternative for SAARC, which due to the India-Pakistan hyphenation.
So you pick up odd country in this grouping. Which country is it? You will pick up. One country is in BIMSTEC, it is called Bay of Bengal Initiative, right? One country is, we can find it very odd, one member country.
Afghanistan, sir. Nepal and Bhutan are also there, sir. So these. Afghanistan is in SAARC. This is not in SAARC.
So Nepal?
Nepal and Bhutan are there, sir.
Why they are odd?
Because they are not actually littoral states, but they form an integral part of the South Asian continent, sir.
Okay. What is the status of BIMSTEC now? What is the accomplishment?
Sir, BIMSTEC has actively contributed in the different kinds of activities like the disaster management part. Also, the trade connectivity across the states is also an important part, especially the IMT trilateral highway and all that.
What is that highway?
Sir, it is to connect the, it is part of the Look East policy, Act East policy of India, that is to provide connectivity to the northeastern states through Bangladesh, and it is part of that to improve our connectivity to Southeast Asia as well, sir. So, the thing is, like, sir, though it has been envisaged as a part of this maritime cooperation, we are yet to get more of it, sir. India is leading.
What is the impact of change in Myanmar politics on this BIMSTEC initiative?
Sir, India has been vocal about democratic politics, sir, but the coup that happened in Myanmar actually places our apprehensions, because the Myanmar army, there are having human rights violations and other issues. So India to engage with a military dominant military dictatorship is having issues, sir.
Can we say BIMSTEC is not a very big success when it comes to India? Because they are not able to, they aimed very high for so many years, but on the ground nothing has come out tangibly. Can you, what are the tangible things? Nothing has come out, no? Just talking.
Sir, tangible outcomes in that sense might be minimal, but the thing is, like, India aiming to be a net security provider in the region, Indian Ocean region, to have a maritime security status and all that, we need the support of the...
India may say so many things, I will provide a security provider in the Indian Ocean. Who is bothered? Sri Lanka is not bothered. Myanmar is not bothered. Bangladesh is also talking, they are having a South Asia plus China grouping and sans India. All empty rhetoric we are speaking, right?
Sir, in between we have lost a hold on these countries, that is so sure. But if you, if we have seen through the latest news, Sri Lanka is willing to come back. They are actually, we have lost on the port project in Sri Lanka to China. But Sri Lanka actually have realized, because of the checkbook diplomacy that China is following, they are facing great debt there. So I hope the goodwill that India holds is going to increase only. So in that sense, sir, all the countries would be in, India is the leader of South Asia, sir.
Okay. Can you think of some initiatives of India to counter Hambantota port?
Sir, we are extending a line of credit, sir, to counter the checkbook diplomacy of China. And also India is actively into rehabilitating the refugees. So, in that sense, India is trying to build that goodwill, and India is also aiming to get the West Container Terminal right now.
That is one part. To counter that, if Hambantota port is this thing, they build it as one of the major ports,
yes,
in the future for this entire region, right?
Yes, sir.
So, do India have any plans of countering with through some other port in India or Indian territory?
Sir, India is actively involved in building strategic locations, be it the Chabahar port in Iran. And India is also actively involved in building its maritime security aspects. So, seen the Lakshadweep or Andaman Nicobar Islands, we are developing it into strategic locations. The recent optic fiber connectivity to Lakshadweep and Andaman Nicobar Islands can be seen as a part of this, sir.
Okay, gold smuggling case in Kerala. Heard of it, no?
Yes, sir.
The gold smuggling was prominent in the news, but in the related related to gold smuggling involving the diplomatic personnel, there are other few cases also. Can you say what are all those cases?
I didn't get you, sir. Can
the gold case, there is an involvement of UAE diplomats,
yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
Or okay, there are in the related to the gold case, offshoot of this gold case, few other cases also came to the notice of the government. Can you say?
Sorry, sir, if it is about the smuggling and the related dollar smuggling also, I mean, accusations are on, sir. I'm not so sure because I'm right now in Ghaziabad. I'm following news from the national dailies only, sir.
How long you are in Ghaziabad?
Sir, for the last 6 months, sir.
Last 6 months only, no?
Yes, sir.
It's all happened before the 20.
Sir, gold smuggling and related, there was a busting of rackets which were actually involved in the smuggling.
What
which
racket?
Of busting of the gold smuggling rackets.
That is okay.
Yes, sir.
Gold is one. Any other smuggling?
Sir, drugs also off late.
Involving embassy?
No, sir. Not embossing. Not involving embassy, sir. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, sir. I'm not able to.
Okay. How Kerala society is different from number one, rest of the South Indian states? and number two, North Indian states. Number three, Northeastern states.
Sir, South Indian states, I have visited Tamil Nadu and Karnataka. One of the important factors that I have noticed is that the level of education in Kerala society is really high. People are really aware about their rights and they will go any extent to gain that. And about the North societies.
That means I ask you to distinguish between Kerala and rest of the South Indian states. When you say literacy is high, the other states' literacy is low. You want to say like that?
No, sir. The impact of literacy on people's awareness of rights, sir. That is what I wanted to focus, sir. Because I have been in Karnataka for field attachment in the last 3 months. One thing that I have observed, people, even though they know that this is their right, they are really in subservient position there, sir. They will come, request and all. But in Kerala, what I have seen from my father's
that
experience...
That level of maturity, no? It is more than awareness.
Sir,
it is level of maturity.
Yeah.
I can say Kerala is a first bencher attitude. Everything I will raise and I will ask questions. Don't you see in that way?
No, sir. Sorry to differ in that, sir. I think if we have a right, we should be really vocal about that. And to get something, we should not be in requesting more.
Okay, what are the other differences? Let us move on.
Sir, other difference, one thing I observed is, especially with respect to the northern states, I have been on offices here. So in the northern state, still the remnants of feudal culture is there, that Babudam, which we call us. So civil servants are more of less seen as gods, demigods. In Kerala, you can never feel that, sir. So if you are an officer, good for you. Okay. Nothing else,
Northeast.
Sir. I have never been to any northeastern states, sir.
You have studied in sociology, right?
Yeah, sir. In northeastern states and in Kerala, especially with respect to my Nair community, one parallel I can draw is the prominence of matriarchy or matrilineal system, sir. In northern states, it's mostly patriarchal and patrilineal.
Good.
Yeah. So,
Sir,
you have
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So how old is this
sport? Ma'am, it dates back to almost Mahabharata times. That's what I read from. So some of the small nation states then used to do this. I'm not really aware about how the independent times, from the independent times itself, this was there in India, ma'am. Mostly it is in India, ma'am. Its variance is found in some other South Asian countries also, ma'am.
Can you name one variant?
I'm not able to recollect, ma'am.
Okay, so we were talking about literacy rate in Kerala. So what contributes to the higher literacy rates in Kerala?
Ma'am.
And what can, you know, the other states do to increase the literacy rates of their states as well?
Ma'am, it has a historical factor as such. As you know, Kerala had some princely states and the kings were really involved in the education of the masses. While as we know in British times, it was mostly the top level literacy and they were not actually bothered about the literacy of masses. So one is the historical factor, ma'am. And the second is the government initiatives in Kerala. The involvement of government in public education, especially the health and education sectors, is very rampant there. You can find high quality schools, government schools, where students can go and study without paying anything. And also that is a generational impact, ma'am. If the first generation gets high education and gets better employment, that obviously motivates the lower the next generations to involve in education, ma'am.
Okay. STEM. There are few women who take up STEM and fewer who pursue STEM. So, and the fewer ones who pursue STEM, they also leave this career and join other, you know, areas, like, you know, so how can this situation be?
Ma'am, this is famously known as the leaky pipes phenomena. Like as the flow increases, the number of people who reach the end service will be very less. So one of the important factors about this is most of the research oriented activities in STEM requires long years of investment. Women, mostly because of their other responsibilities which the society expects from them, were not able to dedicate that much of a time for this. So in that sense, one thing that we can do is the government of India have come up with scholarships for women in the science, technology and other engineering services. So I myself has been a recipient of one of those scholarships where meritorious women candidates will be provided free of cost education in engineering, ma'am. And the other part is providing more employment opportunities for women, especially the Kiran scheme. all these envisages more women in technology sector, and also providing them assistance and backups and making the STEM environment more gender friendly, ma'am.
You said you were inspired by your father. So you had a clarity that you would like to pursue this.
Yes, ma'am.
Then why did you take up?
Ma'am, my clarity came up actually after during my final year exam time, ma'am. What happened was, like, I had a severe hepatitis A infection and I was in my home for almost 3 months. So it was the time I closely observed people coming to meet my father and the kind of interactions that they were having. I was already in the phase of getting a campus placement. Then I thought, like, hefty sum may not satisfy what I need actually. So job satisfaction, it will be better here, ma'am. That's why I shifted to this.
Okay. So, one last question. Intolerance in India. So, it's discussed mostly within the framework of religion and not caste. What are your views?
Ma'am, India has been widely celebrated as a very eclectic state, ma'am, where the mixing of religions actually have happened. India is the only state which has been welcoming to all other religions. That is why we see this diversity of religions here, ma'am. So of late, if that threats of tolerance have been increasing, that is mostly because the behavioral changes in human beings as such, ma'am. One of the main things I would love to explore more about this is, ma'am, the linkage of politics with religion, the rise of communalist trends. So people normally use religion for their own vested interest. So that is one of the main reasons why of late there has been increase in intolerant events, ma'am.